As we all know, our perception towards the life around us is highly governed by our understanding. As kids, we start our journey of understanding the world, and this first-hand experience during the early days of childhood leaves a long-lasting impression. My parents were compassionate about every life form around us. And when I asked about the housekeep, my father used to tell me that they live in our house and in return of this favor, they feed on the insects. Interestingly, with his limited understanding, he used to explain these interesting stuff about various life forms in these ways. Today, when I look at an ant or a tiger, the first thing which I remember are these life lessons. Right exposure at the right time thus brings a positive change. Today, I feel that we need to inculcate the importance of biodiversity into our kids as well. And this is the right time. Thank you.
So when thinking of inculcating the importance of biodiversity in children, the best way I could think of was this one-month program called Zoo Quest by Nidus. I was overwhelmed to see this response we got from the kids and the parents as well. This was 1 month of brainstorming, not just for them, but for me too. Fun and screen-free activities like puzzles, riddles, quiz, art and craft. When, at the end of the program, we asked our green heroes about their understanding of biodiversity, its importance, threats, and what could they do to conserve it. This is what they came up with.
Hi, my name is Aditya.
Hello, my name is Bela Rahul Chowdhury.
Hello everyone, I'm Imadi Sasabi. Today I'm going to talk about biodiversity.
Do you know the meaning of biodiversity?
Biodiversity is from the word biological diversity, which refers to the varieties of life on earth,
like bacteria, plants and animals. Currently, a lot of species are endangered and quite a few are extinct.
Each of these species and organisms work together in ecosystem life and interacted well to maintain balance and support life.
All living things need biodiversity.
Worms help the diversity because they mix the soil, so the plant get easier to spread their roots.
So now I'm explaining you food chain. If there are so many flowers and grass, for grass there are grasshoppers to eat them, and for flowers there are butterflies. And if there are grasshoppers and butterflies all over, so for that there are frogs. And if imagine there are so many frogs, so for that there are snakes. And again imagine there are so many snakes, so for that there are eagles. So now tell me, why I'm not telling you who eats eagle? Because it is on top.
We birds keep control of insects. We also do pollination. Some birds eat their caterpillars. We keep control of plants' growth. We are the farmer's friend. We keep the soil fertile. Marine animals keep control of fish, algae, etc.
Humans affect the biodiversity, or do the humans help biodiversity? Humans help biodiversity by planting more trees, and I have heard that in South Africa a group of people go to different forests and they cut the rhino's horns a little bit off so that they are not killed for their horns. And they humans affect biodiversity by cutting trees, deforestation, cutting trees for building roads, building buildings, and etc.
Biodiversity is under threat because humans are misusing the resources.
Humans are bad. Humans are little in number, but they create big problems. And they are comfortable, but they are hurting the nature.
I have made this drawing of biodiversity where this earth and the gray part. This one means that lots of animals are there on earth, and this gray part means that no animals are left.
We take so many things from Mother Nature, but like other living forms, we don't pay back. Unfortunately, we have no strength that we can pay back the amount to nature we took from her. But we are lucky that some of the part is still not harmed. We can at least save that.
Biodiversity.
To prevent this massive destruction, we need to take care of animals, plant more plants and trees, and stop cutting trees and deforesting the forest.
So we should not kill animals or insects. If at our home cockroaches, lizards are coming, so we are trying to kill them, but we should not. They help us in many things, like at our home some small insects are there, so they eat them. So they help us by eating the small insects which are not, we are not visible to us.
Wherever you go, try to use a cycle.
आपण हे शब्द वाचवले पाहिजे आणि झाडे भरपूर एवढी लावले पाहिजेत की प्राणी येतील, पक्षी येतील, भरपूर फुलपाखरू येतील, पोपट येतील.
We can save biodiversity by planting more trees, not using plastic, keeping the lights off when not needed, using less water during showers, and going to local villages and telling all the knowledge up to them.
I have planted a various of plants in my terrace garden to attract butterflies. I give water for birds in the summer season. I don't kill lizards or other insects. Rather, I started liking them. I don't pluck flowers or stop trees as I come to know that I depend on them more than they depend on me.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
In the last 1 month of interactions with these green heroes, we learned so many things. One of the best lessons we learned is this.
Can't do anything to our biodiversity, just leave it alone. Thank you. Bye.